In this video, we're going to look at an example with life expectancy, and we're going to answer these questions, which are similar to what you have in your homework. Okay. Now, if you can see this chart on your computer screen, that's great. If not, you can print it from the website, but it's optional. You don't have to print anything if you don't want to. And you can also print off these questions, but again, you don't have to print them if you don't want to. But they are on the website if you need them, so it's just an optional thing. Okay, so what's going on here? We have a country. These blue dots represent the actual life expectancy of the people. This is time in years since 1998, and this is the life expectancy. And let's just highlight some numbers here. We've got the year age 72, age 73, age 74. Okay. So, notice that this line isn't going straight through any of the dots. This is not, therefore, this is not a perfectly linear function. It's an almost linear function, though. It's almost linear, but it's not perfect. And a lot of data in real life is like that. It's not perfectly linear, but it's close. So what this straight line is called, it's called a trend line. Okay, this is a trend line. And this gives an approximation for a linear function to kind of map the data. In other words, it'll help us to try to predict what's going to happen in the future. It'll help us to try and predict what the life expectancy is kind of in between these 2 years. What was the life expectancy back here? What is the life expectancy between these years and things like that? So it just helps us to make a good guess at data or numbers that we haven't recorded. So the blue are fact. The blue dots are facts, and the black line is an estimate. Okay. So what we're going to do first is interesting. What we're going to try and answer this question: what is the slope of the trend line, and what is its meaning in practical terms? Okay, we're going to ask that question, but we're also going to just kind of totally understand this formula, right? So we're just going to totally write until we have totally figured this thing out. So on the x-axis we have time in years since 1998. So I'd like you to put down year, and then we've got years since 1998, which is T, okay, and then we've got life expectancy. See, that's T, it's part of the equation here. Okay, so the only way to really figure this out is to start plugging in numbers and calculating things, and then we'll totally understand. Okay, so what we have is we have this formula, which is E equals negative 0.25 times T plus 74.21. Okay, now what does that mean? Let's see. I'll show you what that means now. It means that, now let's understand the relationship between years and these numbers here. This is time in years since 1998. In other words, if this says 2, what year is this? The year. What's 1998 plus 2? 2000, right? This is the year 2000, right? So what does 3 mean? 3 is the year 2000 and 1, because it's 3 years since 1998. What does 1 mean and what does 0 mean? Write them down. 1 year since 1998 is 1999. And 0 years since 1998, what year corresponds to 0 on the x-axis? 1998. Okay, now fill in the rest of the years here. Right? Does that make sense? Now, So if the year is 1998, that's 0 years since 1998. If the year is 1999, that's 1 year since 1998. If the year is 2000, that is 2 years since 1998, and so on. And we'll just do some calculations so we understand what this formula means. What the formula means is, according to the trend line, now this equation corresponds to the trend line, if you, okay? And it means that, let's see, 1998, t is 0, if I calculate this formula, I get negative 0.25 times t, which is 0, see that? 0 plus 74.21. Calculate that, what do you get? And that, of course, is 0 plus 74.21, so that's 74.21. So in 1998, according to the trend line, the life expectancy of the people in this country is 74.21 years. In 1999, the life expectancy is negative 0.25 times 1 plus 74.21. And what does that calculate out to be? Well, that actually gives us negative 0.25 plus 74.21. So the life expectancy is going to decrease because you got a negative added to a positive, right? And it becomes what? What does the life expectancy become with this? 73 point what? On your calculator? 0.96, isn't it? Pretty sure. After 2 years, in the year 2000, life expectancy is going to reduce again. Calculate it, you get negative 0.25 times 2 plus 74.21. So it's going to decrease by 2 negative 0.25s. And what does that give us? Let me just plug it in the calculator. By the way, that gives you negative 0.5. It's going to decrease by a half a year. So in just 2 years, the life expectancy of this country is decreasing by a half a year. Hard to believe. Negative 0.5 plus 74.21, 73.71. Right? In the year 2001, and so on, right? That's 3 years after 1998. It's going to decrease by even more. So I'm hoping you can, if you're writing this down, you might start to see what's going on. This is life after 3 years after 1998, life expectancy is actually decreasing by 3/4 of a year. That's a huge deal. So negative 0.75 plus 74.21, 70. So they're already expecting to live 73.46 years of age. Okay, so they've gone, just in 3 years, they've gone from expecting to live to 74.21 years in 1998 to expecting to live to 73.46 in the year 2000. 2002, that's 4 years later, we have negative 0.25 times 4 plus 74.21. And what's negative 25.4 times 4? Negative 0.25 times 4 is negative 1 plus 74.21. In other words, after 4 years after 1998, their life expectancy has dropped an entire year. And that is a big, big deal. Oh, so that's gone to, whoop, my mistake. This has gone to what? 73.21. So in four short years, life expectancy has dropped from 74.21 years to 73.21 years, and a drop of an entire year. Okay, big deal. By most, you know, kind of richer countries, you know, our life expectancy increases gradually every year with better medicine and everything like that. Okay. So what is the slope is the question. and what is its meaning in practical terms? Can you answer that now? Do you remember what the slope is in this equation? You might remember from algebra a formula which was y equals mx plus b. That's an equation for a linear equation where this letter here is the slope, right? And that's like here the y is e, the x is t, right? But the point is that the slope is what is causing growth or negative or positive or negative growth, basically. It's a negative 0.25, right? That's decreasing the values each time. And so in any case, the slope of this line equals negative 0.25. It's a negative slope, and that's why you see the line as you always read from left to right, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, right? As you go from left to right, the values go down. The life expectancy actually decreases. Okay? So the slope is negative 0.25. And we can just read that from the equation. Now, what's the meaning? Press pause and say the meaning, or write it down. But just press pause and try it, and then I'll do it. Okay, I hope you've tried it. I'm going to do it now. Let's see. You might have come up with a better sentence than me. I'm going to try a sentence. Each year, life expectancy decreases by negative 0.25 on years on average. How about that? Now, what I mean by each year, why do we know? How do we know it's each year? Because look, the years are going up. 1998, 99, 2000. The years are going up by one, and the life expectancy is going down by 0.25 each time. See that after 1 year it goes down negative 0.25, and then it goes down 0.5, and then it goes down by 7.5, and then it goes down by one. So it's going down by 0.25 each year for every extra year. See that? Does that make sense? So, you know, these guys are increasing by one. These guys are increasing by one, whereas the life expectancy is decreasing by 0.25. This is a decrease by 0.25. A decrease by 0.25. Okay, and again, that's the growth rate. The slope is the same as the growth rate. And remember when we did, okay, now we know that the average growth rate equals the change in y's over the change in outputs over the change in inputs. Negative 0.25 over plus 1, which is negative 0.25, right? Obviously, right? So just so you know, this all matches up with what we've been doing. It's the same thing. And the growth rate is the same thing as the slope, right, of a line, of a straight line. So in any case, each year, life expectancy decreases by 0.25 years on average, you have to say, because this black line isn't a fact, it's a estimate. And I just want to quickly match up what this line means with what we calculated on our table. I'll just show you that really quickly if I can. So if we extend that line and look at how this table, it's going 73 is here and 74 is here, okay? So this is like 74.2 or something, right? And if you look at our table, this is the year 1998, and life expectancy, according to the trend line, is 74.21 years. That matches up, doesn't it? It's about 74.21, isn't it? because this is 72, 73, 74, so that's just a little more than 74. In 1999, and so that's 1 point. 1999, we have 73.96, which is almost 71. So if I just go straight up from 1999, see, let's just go straight up from 1999, we get right there, which is just about 74 or 73.96. Same thing, right? The year 2000, we had 73.71. If you go up from the year 2000, you're actually going to miss the actual figure, which was less than that. You're going to hit here, which is 73.71. Okay, this is at 73.71, whereas the real life expectancy is actually lower, right? If you go up from the year 2000, it's, you're practically the same. It's 73.46, and that's practically the same as the real figure that was calculated for this country. Okay, so that's what these, when you plot these points from the table and join them up, that's how you come up with the trend line, basically, right? It follows this equation. And you can get this equation using Microsoft Excel or a graphing calculator, but we're not going to do that in this class. We're just going to use it instead of calculating it. Okay. So the next question is, during which years was life expectancy higher than would have been expected from the linear trend line? Can you answer that question? During which years was life expectancy higher than would have been expected? Press pause and see if you can see. Well, sorry about this dot I did here, but in the year 2002, we actually have a blue dot here, you see? That's a blue, this is the real calculation, and also 2003. So in 2002 and 2003, we can clearly see life expectancy above what the linear trend line would predict. Question 3, during which years was life expectancy lower than would have been expected from the linear trend line? Can you answer that question? When was life expectancy lower? Oops. Let me show you this. When was it lower? How about the year 2000? Here's that real data point that was actually calculated, which is lower than the 73.71 that's predicted by the linear trend line. So that's the year 2000, right? What about a little bit, 2005 is slightly below as well, so you could also say that. But if you just have 2000, that would probably do. If you have a question on this in the homework or on a test, it's going to be very obvious that the points will be completely below the line or completely above. Okay, just so you know. So, if the linear trend line established by these data... Let's look at this question now. If the linear trend line established by these data persisted through 2008, what would be the life expectancy of a child born in 2008? By all means, press pause and try and solve that. I guess I'll give you one hint. You could use the table we've been using. In other words, you could use this formula, right? Does that make sense? Or you could also look at the graph. Which would be more accurate, though, to use the table or to use the formula or the graph? Anyway, if we just look at the graph first of all, and we can just kind of extend this line on a bit, which I did. So if I extended that line, okay. Where is 2008? Where is the year 2008? It's 10 years since 1998, so it's here, right? What life expectancy does that correspond to? 72 is here, 71.8 is here. So it's just about 71.8 or just below 71.8. So we get approximately 71.8 from the graph, but that's not an exact answer, is it? Can't really get an exact answer from a graph. Well, at least we can use it to check. If we get something close to that, then we're probably right. Okay? So let's use the formula to calculate that. So if the year is 2008, how many years since 1998 is that? Write it down. 2008 is how many years since 1998? It is 10 years, right? And so what do you plug in for T? T is years since 1998, because you want to calculate what E is, life expectancy. So it's negative 0.25 times T plus 74.21, right? So you plug 10 in for T and calculate that, right? So by all means, put that in your calculator and figure out what it is. So this would be negative 2.5 anyway, right? What does that give you? Right? 71.71. Now, is that close to what we predicted from the graph? When we had the graph, we said, well, maybe just about 71.8 or maybe a little less than it. So we got about 71.71. We got exactly 71.71 according to the graph. So 71.71 years is the answer there to two decimal places. If you're rounding to one decimal place, it would be what? Rounding to one decimal place, 71.7 years, right? Rounding to the nearest whole number, it would be approximately 72 years. So just read the question. Sometimes it's going to ask for one decimal place, sometimes two decimal places, sometimes the nearest whole number, and you got to be able to round, okay? Anyway, so can you do this one? If the linear trend established by these data persisted through 2011, what would be the life expectancy of a child born in 2011? Please press pause and do that one yourself. 2011, and you do it the same way, right? The year is 2011, and the first step is to figure out how many years is that since 1998, and that is where I think you want to be careful. Don't make that mistake, otherwise the whole thing would be wrong, right? So watch out for that. Okay, I hope you've pressed pause and tried it. I'm going to do it quickly now. 2011 is 13 years since 1998. To calculate life expectancy, it's negative 0.25 times 13 plus 74.21. Plug that in the calculator. And we should get 70.96 negative, 25 times 13, okay. So this is negative 3.25 plus 74.21, which made in the end 70.96. So, or, and if you're asked to round this to the nearest, by the way, just for fun, to, oh yeah, we'll put this there. Okay, so we get 70.96, right? Round that to the nearest to one decimal place, and what would that be? Or to the nearest tenth. If you round that to the nearest tenth, what do you get? Well, you get 71 or 71.0, if you know what I mean, because the 6 would round up and then this becomes like a 10 and the 1 gets added on here. So rounding to the nearest tenth and round to the nearest whole number, what do you get when you round to the nearest whole number? You get 71. So it's the same thing, right? If you round to the nearest tenth or round to the nearest whole number with this, you get the same thing. Anyway, Okay, press pause, do this one. If the linear trend established by these data persisted through 2030, what would be the life expectancy of a child born in 2030? Now really press pause and do this, and I definitely will let you do it, and then I'll go back and I'll do it really quickly, okay? To check. Does this age seem reasonable? So I hope you've pressed pause and tried it. I'm going to do it really quickly now. The year 2030 is how many years since 1998? It is 30 years to 2000 and another 2. It's 32 years since 1998. Negative 0.25 times 32 plus 74.21 would make what? It would make negative 8. Plus 74.21 and that is 66.21 years, and I guess that's, is that reasonable? I think it is reasonable, don't you? I mean, it's possible that a country could have a life expectancy of that, especially if conditions worsen as they seem to have been doing. Well, how about the year 2200 for fun? How many years is that since 1998? The year 2200 since 1998 would be 202 years, and life expectancy would be this. That times 202 plus 74.21. I guess that's not, negative 0.25 times 202. So that is negative 50.5 plus 74.21. So that is 23.71, which I guess is pretty crazy. I mean, are conditions in this country really going to keep getting worse and worse and worse, to where a child born only expects to live to the age 23, when, you know, in 1998 they expect to live to 74? So that's a, that would be a striking difference. So you would hope that, I guess if you had a heart, you would hope that the conditions wouldn't decrease that much. But in any case, that's what we would use a linear trend line for. And the other thing, the last thing I want to make a note of, is that a linear function for in many applications in real life is good for predicting values like 2008 maybe, or 2007 or 2006. It's good for predicting close by information, but it's not good for predicting far into the future. And I mean, to think that life expectancy could go all the way to 23 and just keep getting worse and worse and worse, I mean, that's a bit of a gamble. I don't think it would really do that. And let me just show you what has happened in this country. Okay, so this is, we have data all the way from 2005, okay, to 2000. So we just have 2000 to 2005, okay. And we're just this line, we use that data, and we made this linear trend line, and we made predictions with it. Well, this is actually the life expectancy of the country, and 2000 is here, this point, and then we had this point, this point, this point, this point, and this point. So we were looking at these red points here, okay, and just to prove that linear trend lines are only good for, and so our linear trend line went like this, you know, something like this. And just to prove that linear trend lines are only good for predicting in between points and real close into the future, not too far, you could make a really silly prediction for what's going to happen later on. Because even in 2008, this is 2008, and in 2008, you can see life expectancy. See, this is 72 years, this is 74 years, this is 73 years. See that? Life expectancy is starting to actually go back up. This is 2009, 2010, 2011. So, and So there you go. We don't use linear trend lines to predict things far into the future because you can be very, very wrong. So here you can see what really happened in this country was life expectancy increased. It came to about 1995, and then it started to decrease. 2008, it started to increase again. So you might be interested to know which country this is. I'm not going to say, but I will say this. How do they calculate life expectancy? Well, they calculate things like how many infants who are born expect to live, how many infants expect to survive, do they expect to survive diseases, and how many are malnourished and that type of thing. Because if you have a high infant mortality rate, then that really reduces the average number of years you would expect to live. And so basically between 1995 all the way to 2008, they had a serious problem with babies dying, didn't have enough medicine or food, malnutrition, so a lot of starvation, a lot of disease, and war and whatnot. And that started to improve, and believe it or not, the medicine and food for this country was actually forcibly kept out. They were forcibly not allowed to import medicine and food, and most of the deaths occurred in children under the age of 5. And so we're lucky we don't live here, huh? So anyway, that's their life expectancy, and it's starting to increase now. Things seem to be getting a little bit better. Let's hope they do.